Today's curiosity is assisted by Nato La Shop Stout from La Shop Brasserie in St. Boniface, Winnipeg, Manitoba. Seems to be a trend of not having tasting notes on the can anymore, just a wee story. Bit lighter than you'd expect from a stout, but still lots of malty roastiness. Decent beer for tinkering around here. So today, I'm going to take a look at these two things. These are curb finds that I picked up a few weeks ago. These monsters are model DA88-12W-1. These are transformers for outdoor lighting. 120 volts input, 12V AC, 7.3 amps, or 88 VA out. So on the front, under the little cover, we have a resettable circuit breaker. You have what appears to be a photocell under a little lens. And we have a knob, which allows us to set it to positions off, on, auto, 4-hour, 6-hour, and 8-hour. Now on the back side, we have the AC input, and we have the two output connections. That one does not look like it's very securely secured. On the back, you can just barely see embossed a couple of date codes. The one on the right looks like it's from 2018, and the one on the left looks like it's from 2016. And the screws are slightly different too. For my teardown, I think I will take the older one just because it's the older one. No other reason. Let's see if it works before we take it apart. Why not? First, we'll just make sure it's set to the on position. Yes, those are actually heavy. And then we'll see. Oh, right. Guess we should be checking for AC volts. There you go. 13 volts with no load on it. So it's not super tightly regulated, but it is putting out pretty much what it promises. Looking online, I was actually able to find a data sheet for this, which is a little surprising. And they're actually still selling a version of this. It's got a slightly different suffix, but they are still selling these. So here we go with the specs. 120 volts, 100 watts, 60 hertz, of course. 12 volt output, 7.33 amps. Output with no load, 12.8. We were at 13.1, so that's pretty close. The different control modes, as we saw, off, photocell control on, automatic is also photocell control on, and then 4, 6, and 8 hours. Basically, it will, at dusk, it'll start running, and then it'll just go for that long, and then shut off, so that you're not lighting up your yard at 4 a.m. or 6 a.m. or whatever. Operating temperatures, only down to minus 10. That's a little bit warm for a Canadian winter. Although I guess they'd be buried in snow, so it wouldn't be any point in having your path lit. But here's what we're interested in. There's actually a schematic. So the circuit breaker is on the 12 volt output. There's a thermal fuse on the input, a relay, and then a control circuit, and then just a basic transformer. What I'm hoping to get out of this is actually to salvage that transformer, because that is a very useful transformer voltage. But for today, I am really interested in seeing what that control circuit looks like. It looks like these are some kind of a hex bit, bigger than that one. There we go. So that's a 3mm hex. Okay. And I suppose just to make life easier, I'll take these output cables off just to get them out of my way. Fairly stout screws on there. That's nice to see. I mean, it is UL listed, so it's gone through North American safety testing. So I would expect this is a reasonably solid device. Screws feel like they're into nice, soft plastic, just self-tapping in. Fairly decent amount of length. Okay, so with that out, I think I'll pop this cover off because I don't think we'll be needing that anymore. Oops. Definitely won't be needing that anymore. I'm guessing now that I just have to pry it apart somehow. Which part comes off? There we go. As expected, one big beast of a transformer. This is the circuit breaker, so that will be the output side. Yeah, because that's going straight to that output screw there. The other side of the output is coming from over there. Huh. Well, the relay was on the input side. That makes sense. So the black and white wires are the input. How is that control board held in there? Ah, yes, there's a nut under that sticker. Okay. That loosens up quite easily. That's nice. Nice that I didn't have to get something heavy duty in there. All right. With that out of the way, you can lift that control circuit out and, well, there's not too much going on in there. Oh, there's two circuit boards. Okay. Just yoink those connectors off. Oops. That one just came right out of its solder. Doesn't look like it was all that well soldered. Huh. So we got L1 and L2, N1 and N2. Oh, I didn't notice that before. There is our thermal fuse down in there. And I guess just that black goop that's sort of vaguely insulating everything was kind of covering that, but there's strands hanging out there and everything. That's not great. But I guess that's on the output side. That's low voltage, so it's not going to arc and spark over. Right, so there's the transformer separated. There's the input separated. And here is the board separated. So here's what we've got on the first of the two boards. This capacitor here looks like it's going to be for a capacitive dropper. Yeah, it's in series right there. We have four diodes there, which are no doubt a bridge rectifier, and a fifth one over there, which is going to be in parallel with the relay coil. Couple of capacitors there, smaller diode there, which is likely going to be a Zener diode, so that's all power supply. 0.1 microfarad, 275 volt X2, class X2 capacitor for interference, and that is connected between one side of that capacitor and the neutral output. The relay itself, a transistor which will be driving the relay, a couple of power supply smoothing capacitors, and then on the back of that board there are three solder connections up to this other board here, which is more the timing and control stuff. So we have a chip there, GR01 or GR01. Don't recognize that. I'll have to look that up in a minute. We have this 5-pin device here, which is actually a 4-section single inline package resistor. The dot indicates the common, and then that's one resistor there, that's another one there, and so on all the way along. 104, so that's probably a 10K resistor, I would expect. There's the photocell, an old school cadmium sulfide cell. There's another one of those cell resistors and another one over there. So those, I'm guessing, will be interacting with the various switch positions here to tell this thing, depending on which set of resistors are switched in, to tell this thing what its timing is to switch the relay on and off for that 4-hour, 6-hour, and 8-hour setting. So what is this guy here? That's going to be a hard one to look up, I think. Well, after not finding any of those IC numbers on the internet, things escalated quickly. Since many of the other components are labeled, I was hoping that this one would have a label underneath it, but alas, it doesn't. And none of those numbers would find me anything in any combination, including searching, looking for an 18-pin chip, anything with a timing IC just came up with 555s, because why wouldn't it? But having the two boards separated gives us a bit better chance to look at the backside of this guy. So you can see where that chip used to be, and you can see traces going from the switch going to one side of it, and traces going from these sill resistors all going connecting to it, and then the capacitor, the photocell all connecting to it. So yeah, that is very likely to be some sort of a timing IC, perhaps with a comparator or something, so that it can interpret what this photocell is doing. Unfortunately, without knowing what that chip is, there's not much more that this can tell us. Also, not too much more we can learn from this side. This pad here, of the three pads that connect the two board, that one goes to a resistor, a series resistor at the base of that transistor, which controls that relay. And that relay, as we saw before, is connected to the one side of the AC, to the neutral side, just like the datasheet that we found online shows. That was interesting, frustrating, because I couldn't find that part number. So now all that's left is, do I actually pull this thing out of here? Because that is solidly glued in there. That's an epoxy. That ain't coming out. I think what I will do is just splice those two together and put the two output leads onto those screw terminals. So I've got a circuit breaker on the output side, which is good. And basically I've come up with, what do we call this? Just a transformer, just a 12 volt transformer. Unfortunately, no center tap. That would have been really handy. But regardless, just having a 12 volt transformer, or two of them, where's the other one? It's on the floor here, that I can use to power basic power supplies is going to be really handy around here. Especially since this is a curb find and transformers are really, really expensive. They're not as commonly used, at least not mains transformers. They're not as commonly used these days in power supplies since everything's switching. So nice to get my hands on those. And what did I say they were? 70 volt amps, something like that. Yeah, so 7.3 amps at 12 volts. That is going to be very useful for powering, you know, pretty much anything. Just make a linear regulator after it for DC if I want to run masses of LEDs or something like that. That will be useful. And I do like having old school analog power supplies, linear regulators, rather than switching, because as we saw a few videos back, all these switching power supplies around here just generate so much electrical noise, and I don't need that when I'm trying to figure out a circuit and look at it on the scope. I don't need all that noise. So with this, I should be able to build power supplies that don't create all that excess noise. Well, thanks for watching. That was kind of quick and a little anticlimactic because of this anonymous little dude. Questions or comments down below as usual. Thanks for watching. I will talk to you later.